Well, I don't think anybody can be around Sister Carol for very long without understanding that she is influential in a quiet, strategic, interesting way. She listens to people, she figures out who can effectively work together and brings them together. And that's what a real leader does.
I think that Sister Carol is a person of influence simply because she's dedicated and she works hard, but she also has a passion for her work.
There's one project that I worked with Sister Carol on. It was the good health of the American people. Of course, the centerpiece of so much of our work was around the Affordable Care Act. And if there was one word that would describe Sister Carol in that respect, it was courage. She not only had courage, she enabled other people to have courage to do the right thing.
I remember one time traveling with Sister Carol. We were actually at the Vatican, and we were going up some steps, and there was this big portrait of St. Joan of Arc. And she pointed to that. She said, "This is what ministry is about." That remark reminded me that, yes, she felt the heat. It was not fun, it was not pleasant. But in the end, what are we fighting for?
Sister Carol has this ability, this charm, this grace, this look in her eyes that allows her to win over a room and win over a set of people on an issue. And in some respects, it always starts because I think she's almost always right.
When healthcare was under sort of attack, relative to what do not-for-profit hospitals provide in the community, she took the leadership role in this area, working with both Senators Grassley as well as Senator Baucus at the time towards moving and creating an environment that shed light on the tremendous contributions, especially in the area of community benefit, that hospitals actually were involved with.
Being an advocate for covering the uninsured has certainly been one of the strongest contributions that she has made over the years, making sure that the public understands the benefit that hospitals provide to their communities has been really important. But more than anything else, she's able to talk about healthcare from the perspective of the patient.
I think there are tens of millions of people. They will never have heard the name Sister Carol, many of them. Many of whom are struggling to take care of their families that owe Sister Carol that ability that they now have to provide for their families.
The Haiti earthquake was just a pure tragedy. There were so many people who lost their lives. And St. Francois was a very important hospital. It was the first hospital in the urban setting that served the very poor. And it was leveled to the ground. So Sister Carol and the staff convened the different Catholic systems, raised the fund for it. Their vision for the hospital at first was not the same vision as what we had, and of course we wanted it to be better. And this is another genius of Sister Carol. She invited the Haiti church, the bishops and different people to come and take a tour of Catholic hospitals in the U.S. so that they could start thinking of what can be.
She cares about the poor. She cares about people who are at the margins of society. She gave the term field hospital to the life of the church even before Pope Francis did. And I think that is something that she will be remembered for and has made a great contribution to our hospital systems.
Sister, you've been a great colleague, a wonderful friend, and a real mentor to so many in this field, including myself.
Sister Carol, congratulations. Please don't flee the scene. We need you now more than ever.
Sister Carol, you'll be missed, but I can't wait to see what the next chapter brings.
You are a treasure to the church and someone that will continue to inspire all of us as we continue the great legacy that you have begun and invested your life in. Congratulations.
So Sister Carol, enjoy every minute, not of your retirement, but of your refirement. God bless you.